Hello friends, today I am going to present some examples from first unit on the topic linear simultaneous equations. First example, investigate the values of lambda and mu so that the equations 2x plus 3y plus 5z is equals to 9. Second equation, 7x plus 3y minus 2z is equals to 8. Third equation, 2x plus 3y plus lambda times z is equals to mu have no solution. Second, unique solution. And third, infinite number of solution. Here, it is not to solve the equation, but to determine the values of this lambda and mu, unknown quantities, for these three different conditions. Means for what values of lambda mu we have no solution, for what values of lambda mu we get unique solution, and for what values of lambda and mu we have infinite number of solution. And to determine these values of lambda and mu, we write down the given system of equation. Here the terms on the right hand side not equals to zero. Therefore, the type of this equation is non-homogeneous, and therefore we try to apply the technique of finding the solution of non-homogeneous simultaneous equation. First step, write down the augmented matrix by combining matrix A and matrix D. That matrix we have here. In the first row, we have the elements 2, 3, 5, and the right-hand side term is 9. From second row, we have 7, 3, minus 2, and 8. And from last row, or last equation, we have 2, 3, lambda, and mu. This is that augmented matrix. Then we try to convert this augmented matrix to its canonical form by converting all the principal diagonal elements to non-zero and lower diagonal elements to zero by applying the transformation. Here, with the help of 2, it is somewhat difficult to make it zero. Therefore, we try to convert the second diagonal element to 1 by applying the transformation. 7 minus 6 we get 0, and therefore for that we apply the transformation R2 minus 3 times R1, and if we apply that transformation we get we have first row no change, 2, 3, 5 and 9. 7 minus 3 to the 6, 7 minus 6 we get 1 here. 3 minus 3 to the 9, 3 minus 9 we get minus 6. Minus 2 minus 3, 5 is a 15. Minus 2 minus 15 we get minus 17. And then lambda minus, 8 minus 9, 3 is a 27. 8 minus 27. 18. Third row no change as it is. 2, 3, lambda and mu. Then we interchange these two rows so that we get here leftmost element as 1. Therefore, next transformation is by R12. We have first row as 1, minus 6, minus 17 and minus 19. Second row becomes 2, 3, 5 and 9. Third row as it is no change, 2, 3, lambda and mu. Then, with the help of this 1, we try to convert this to zeros by using transformation. Two minus two, we get zero. Therefore, for that we have to apply the transformation R 2 minus 2 times R 1. And for this 2 minus 2, we get zero. The required transformation is R 3 minus again 2 times R 1. Therefore, applying this 2, we have. We get first row no change, 1, minus 6, minus 17, and minus 19. 2 minus 2, we get 0. 3 minus minus plus 6 to the 12. 3 plus 12, we get 15. Then 5 minus and minus it become plus 17 to the it is 34. 5 plus 34 we get 39. Then 9 plus 38 we get 47. Third row by this transformation, 2 minus 2, we get 0, 3 plus 6 to the 12, 3 plus 12, we get again 15, then lambda plus 17 to the 34, then mu plus 19 to the 38. Okay. After completing all this, converting all the elements to zero, we go for the second diagonal element. It is 15 non-zero, and with the help of this 15, we can convert it to zero by applying the transformation R3 minus R2, and if we apply it, we get first row no change, 1 minus 6 minus 17 minus 19. Second row also no change, 0, 15, 39 and 47. Changes in the third by this 0 minus 0, 0. 15 minus 15, we get 0. Lambda plus 34 minus 39. Therefore, 34 minus 39, we get lambda minus 5. And mu plus 38 minus 47, we get mu minus 38 minus 47. We get minus 9. Mu minus 9. Here, first diagonal element is non-zero, second is also non-zero, and we keep this as it is, as we require to obtain the values of lambda and mu. And lower diagonal elements I have converted to zero. Therefore, whatever this form we are getting is the canonical form. And after getting canonical form, we try to determine the values first for no solution. The required condition is rank of A is not equal to rank of augmented matrix, and that is possible if and only if rank of A and rank of AD are not equal, means rank of A is 2 and rank of AD is 3, if lambda minus 5 is equal to 0, If this one is 0, the rank of A is 2, then rank of A, number of non-zero rows, first two are non-zero, we get rank as 2. And this one, rank of that augmented matrix as 3, if this one is non-zero. And lambda minus 5 equals to 0 or not equals to 0. For this value, then rank of augmented matrix is 3. And therefore, these two ranks are not equal. And for that, we get a no solution. Means, for lambda equals to 5, and mu is not equals to 9, we get no solution. Or these are the values of lambda and mu for no solution. Then we go for the second case. For unique solution, the required condition is rank of A is equals to rank of augmented matrix, and that is equals to number of unknowns. And that number of unknowns here, 3, rank for A and rank of augmented matrix must be 3, and that is possible if and only if this lambda minus 5 is not equals to 0, then we get rank of A as 3, and whatever the value of mu, whether it is equals to 0, mu minus 9 equals to 0, mu minus 9 is not equals to 0, and any value of mu. That is, we get lambda is not equals to 5 and any value of mu. For these values, we get unique solution for which this condition will be satisfied. Rank of A equals to rank of augmented matrix, and both ranks must be 3. For this condition, we get a unique solution. And then we go for the last one. For infinite number of solution, required condition is rank of A is equals to rank of augmented matrix, but it must be less than number of unknowns. It must be less than number of unknowns, and that is possible if and only if rank of A must be less than 3, means it must be 2, and for that rank as 2, this term must be 0. Lambda minus 5 equals to 0. If lambda minus 5 equals to 0, then we get rank of A as 2. Rank of augmented matrix also must be 2. And for that, this term must be 0, and as well as mu minus 9 is also equals to 0. then if both are zero, then rank of that augmented matrix we get as 2. And therefore, for lambda equals to 5 and mu equals to 9, we get infinite number of solutions. Like this, we can determine the values of lambda and mu. Once again, quickly I will repeat the steps. First step, write down augmented matrix. Then try to convert that augmented matrix to its canonical form. And after getting canonical form, discuss the different cases. For no solution, the required condition is rank of A is not equal to rank of augmented matrix. And that is possible if and only if this element is 0 and second element is not equal to 0. Means we get lambda equals to 5 and mu is not equals to 9. For these values we get no solution. For unique solution the required condition is rank of A and rank of augmented matrix must be equals to number of unknowns, and that unknowns are here 3. And we get rank as 3 if this two terms are not equals to 0, means lambda minus 5 is not equals to 0, and this may be 0 or may not be 0, means for any value of mu, means for lambda is not equals to 5 and for any value of mu we get in unique solution. And for infinite number of solution, rank of A and rank of AD must be equals to 2, and that is possible if both the elements are equals to 0, means we get lambda equals to 5 and mu equals to 9. Like this, we can determine the values of lambda and mu. Second example, for what values of k the equations have solution, and then solve it completely. In each case, equations are x plus y plus z is equals to 1. Second equation, 2x plus y plus 4z is equals to k. Third equation, 4x plus y plus 10z is equals to k square. Here, the terms on the right hand side, first term is non-zero, and that's why it is non-homogeneous type. And two equations containing the term of k, and we require to obtain the value of k, and then we have to solve it completely. That is the problem. And therefore the first step is again writing the augmented matrix, matrix of combination of matrix A and matrix D. That matrix is here, coefficients of first equation 1 1 1 1, coefficient from second 2 1 4 k, third coefficients are 4 1 10 and k square. Okay, then again we try to convert this to its canonical form by converting all the principal diagonal elements to non-zero and lowest to 0. Therefore, with the help of this one, I will convert these two elements to 0 by applying the row elementary transformation. 2 minus 2, we get 0. Therefore, R2 minus 2 times R1, we get required 0 here. 4 minus 4, we get 0. Means for that, the transformation required is R3 minus 4 times R1. And therefore, we have first row no change, changes in second and third by this 2 minus 2 times 1, 2 minus 2 we get 0, 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2 we get minus 1, 4 minus 2 we get 2, and k minus 2, then R3 minus 4 times R1, 4 minus 4 we get 0, 1 minus 4 times 1, 1 minus 4 we get minus 3, 10 minus 4, 10 minus 4 we get 6, and k square minus 4. Okay. Then, with the help of the second diagonal element minus 1, which is not 0, we try to convert this remaining elements below it to 0. Minus 3 plus 3 we get 0, and therefore the transformation required is R3 minus minus, therefore minus 3 times R2, and therefore if we apply it, we have first two rows no change, 1 1 1 1, second also no change, 0 minus 1 2 and k minus 2. Changes in the third by this 0 minus 3 times 0 we get 0, minus 3 plus 3 we get 0 here, 6 minus 3 to the 6 we get 0, and next k square minus 4 minus 3 times k minus 2. Okay. This is, therefore, I have converted all the principal diagonal elements as non-zero, and in the process, third diagonal becomes 0 and no element available below it so that we can make it non-zero. Therefore, we have to keep that 0 as it is. We stop the calculations here. And then we call this as the canonical form. And after getting canonical form, we have to determine the rank of A. Here the rank of A, number of non-zero rows from this matrix A. First two rows are non-zero rows. Therefore, rank of A is here 2. And for solution, rank of augmented matrix also must be 2. And rank of augmented matrix is we required as 2. And that is possible if and only if this element has 0, that is k square minus 3k and plus 6 minus 4. 6 minus 4 we get plus 2 as 0. Means for these values of k, we get ranks as equal, and here rank of A is equals to rank of augmented matrix, and that is equals to 2, which is less than number of unknowns. Unknowns are here 3, and therefore when rank is equal and less than number of unknowns, then system has infinite number of solution. Okay, and then we try to solve this equation. The factors of that 2 are 1 and 2. And therefore, if you try to factorize this equation, the factors are k minus 2 and k minus 1 equals to 0. The product of these two is plus 2, and the sum of this minus 2 and minus 1 is minus 3. and then equating each to 0, we get k is equals to 1 and k equals to 2. Therefore, these are the values of k for which we get infinite number of solution. And then after getting the values, we have to solve it completely. Therefore, we try to substitute the value of k equals to 1 here to get first matrix, and then we try to solve it. Then for k equals to 2, we have another system of equation, and then we try to solve it completely. For k equals to 1, that matrix of A and D, augmented matrix, is equals to first row 1, 1, 1, 1, then second row 0, minus 1, 2, and when k is, if we put here 1, 1 minus 2, we get minus 1, 0, 0, 0, and if we put k as 1, this term becomes 0. And for k equals to 2, that augmented matrix we have as first row, no change, 1, 1, 1. Third row, second row, 0, minus 1, 2. And 2 minus 2, we get here 0. And last row, 0, 0, 0, and 0. And therefore, we have to write down the new system of equation and then try to get that infinite number of solution. Therefore, multiplying this by that column matrix of x, y, z, new system is multiplying by that first row to that column, we get first equation as x plus y plus z is equals to 1. First equation, multiplying by this second row to that column, we get 0x minus y plus 2z is equals to minus 1. Second equation, 0x plus 0y plus 0z is equals to 0. We have only two equations. And then applying the technique of solving the system of equation for infinite solution. Last equation is containing two variables or unknowns, y and z. Any one of them we consider as k, therefore let we consider z as k suppose, then if we put that value of z here, we get the value of y from equation 2, we get, I will transfer this to right and this to left, therefore we get y is equals to 1 plus 2z, and therefore we get, if we put the value of z as k, we get here y as 2k plus 1. Substituting these two in first, therefore from 1, we get x is equals to 1 minus y minus z, 1 minus y, the value of y is 1 plus 2k, and minus z, the value of z as k, and therefore we have 1 minus 1 get cancelled, minus 2k minus k, we get minus 3k, and therefore the required solution is x is equals to minus 3k, y is equals to k, 2k plus 1, and z is equals to k. And whether the obtained solution is correct or not, for that we cross check it by considering some value for k. Suppose for k is equals to 1. 1. We have the values of x as 3 into 1 we get minus 3. Y as 2 plus 1 we get 3. And z as k, k is 1. Therefore, this is one of the solution out of that infinite. And then we quickly cross check it whether equations are satisfied or not. Therefore, if we put the values in the first, minus 3 plus 3, 0, and z is 1. 1 equals to 1. First equation is satisfied. Then second equation, y is 3, therefore minus 3 plus 2. Minus 3 plus 2, we get minus 1. Equation second is also satisfied. And as both the equations are satisfied, whatever the answer obtained is the correct one. Then we go for the second one. Here the new system is again multiplying by that column matrix for this matrix A or two matrix A. We have the equations as x plus y plus z is equals to 1. Again, first equation. Second equation. 0x minus y plus 2z is equals to 0, second equation. And then solving it as per the technique of solving infinite solution, for infinite solution. Here also once again we have two unknowns y and z. Consider any one of them as k. Therefore let z as k suppose. Substituting that value in equation 2, we get the value of y, transferring to other side. We get y is equals to 2z and the value of z as k, and therefore we get y as 2k. Substituting this in first, from 1 we have the value of x as 1 minus y minus z. And therefore, we get 1 minus y, y is 2k, and z is k, and therefore, we have 1 minus 3k. And therefore, the required solution is x is equals to 1 minus 3k, y is equals to 2k, and z is equals to k. And then we cross check for some values for k. Once again, suppose k equals to 1, for k equals to 1, we have the values as 1 minus 3 we get minus 2, y is equals to 2 into 1 we get 2, and z as k, therefore z is equals to 1. Therefore, these are the values for x, y, z, one of the solution out of infinite. And then for these values, we cross check it whether equations are satisfied or not. If satisfied, then obtained answer is the correct one. If anyone is not satisfied, then answer is the wrong one. Therefore, I will substitute the values minus 2 plus 2, 0, and plus z, 1, 1 equals to 1. First equation is satisfied. Then we cross check for the second, y is 2, therefore minus 2 plus 2 times 1. Minus 2 plus 2 we get 0, 0 equals to 0. Therefore, equation 2 is also satisfied. And as both the equations are satisfied, the obtained answer is correct one. Like this, always try to cross check whether it is a homogeneous type or non-homogeneous type of equation. We take a note to find the solution of homogeneous type of equation, or alternative way to to find the solution of a homogeneous type of equation if that canonical form technique is not applicable or useful. There are two points. Point number one, if determinant of A is equal to 0, then there exists an infinite number of solution or non-zero solution. And second case, if determinant of A is not equal to 0, then there exists unique solution or zero solution. Therefore, we try to use this note to solve the homogeneous type of equation. First example, find the value of lambda so that the system has non-trivial solution or non-zero solution. Equations are 1 minus lambda times x plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 0. Second equation, 3x plus, again in bracket, 1 minus lambda times y plus 2z is equal to 0. Third equation, 2x plus 3y plus, in bracket, 1 minus lambda, bracket close, into z is equal to 0. Here all the values on the right hand side equals to 0 means it is a homogeneous type of equation, and it is somewhat difficult to perform by that canonical method as each row containing the term of 1 minus lambda. Calculation becomes somewhat difficult to perform, and therefore we are not using that technique. We use this another technique, alternative technique, by finding the value of determinant. Therefore, we try to find out determinant of A, means determinant of matrix A. Matrix A means matrix of coefficient of the variables. Therefore, that determinant becomes here. Here the coefficients are 1 minus lambda, 2, 3. Second row, coefficients are 3, 1 minus lambda, 2. And third row, coefficients are 2, 3, and 1 minus lambda. Okay. And then we try to find the value of this determinant as usual. We are finding the value of determinant. Therefore, it is equals to first element, 1 minus lambda. Neglecting this column and this row, containing it, and then determinant of the remaining, and therefore determinant of the remaining, I will perform the calculation directly here. This product minus this product, therefore that product is 1 minus lambda into 1 minus lambda means square of it minus 3 to the 6. We get this one. Then the second element with minus and minus 2, neglecting this row and this column and taking a determinant of the remaining 4 elements, and therefore the value of that determinant is this into this. We get 3 into 1 minus lambda minus this product 2 to the 4, then plus 3 into, neglecting the first one, this column, and then taking the determinant of the remaining 4 elements, and therefore the determinant is, finding the value, 3 is a, we get 9 minus this product 2 times 1 minus lambda. And then simplifying it, we get first term 1 minus lambda as it is. Expanding this by a minus b whole square, a square 1 square minus 2ab 2 lambda plus b square, we get lambda square minus 6, then minus 2 times, simplifying this, 3 into 1 we get 3, minus 3 lambda minus 4, then plus 3 times, simplifying it, it is 9 minus 2 minus minus, it becomes plus 2 lambda. And therefore it is equals to. Multiplying, first we write in simplified form, 1 minus lambda into, the terms are lambda square minus 2 lambda, 1 minus 6 we get minus 5, then minus 2 times, it is 3 minus 4. Minus 1 minus 3 lambda plus 3 times 2 lambda and 9 minus 2, 9 minus 2 we get plus 7. And then multiplying or simplifying it, we have, therefore it is equals to 1 into this term, we get the same term, therefore lambda square minus 2 lambda minus 5, then multiplying by this lambda to each term, we get minus lambda cube, minus minus plus 2 lambda square, and then minus minus plus 5 lambda. Then we take minus sign common from this, therefore minus minus it becomes plus 2 into 1, 2. Then plus 3 to the 6 lambda. Then plus again 6 lambda. And 7 to the 21, plus 21. And we try to simplify it here. Highest term is of lambda cube, therefore minus lambda cube, lambda square plus 2 lambda square, we get plus 3 lambda square, 5 plus 17 minus 2, we get 15 lambda, and then 21 plus 2, 23 minus 5, we get 18. This is the value of determinant of A. And for non-zero solution or and infinite number of solution, the required condition is determinant of A must be equals to 0. That is, this determinant value is minus lambda cube plus 3 lambda square plus 15 lambda plus 18. That must be equals to 0. Now multiplying by minus sign throughout, we get that is lambda cube minus 3 lambda square minus 15 lambda minus 18 equals to 0. We have a cubic equation. And then we try to solve it for lambda to determine the values of lambda for this condition or to have that infinite number of solution. Equation is lambda cube minus 3 lambda square minus 15 lambda minus 18 equals to 0. Therefore, as it is a cubic equation, we try to solve it by synthetic division technique. We write down the coefficient in decreasing order 1, then minus 3, then minus 15, and minus 18. We apply this trial and error technique to determine the values of lambda. If sum of all the coefficient is 0, then 1 is the root. Here that sum is not equal to 0. If alternate sum is equal, 1 minus 15 we get minus 16, and here the sum of this is minus 21, not equals, therefore minus 1 is also not the root. Then we check for plus 2, minus 2, plus 3, minus 3 like this, and therefore here by performing all that we have our first element we take as it is 1. 1 into 6 we get 6. Sum of this as 3. 6 threes are 18. 18 minus 15 we get 3. And again 6 threes are 18. Minus 18 plus 18 we get 0. And as last sum is 0, lambda is equals to 6. Is the first value. If you remove one factor from this cubic equation, the second factor is lambda square plus 3 lambda plus 3 equals to 0. Here we are not able to get the factors of 3, so that we get the product as 3 and sum as 3. Means here real roots are not possible. Therefore, we try to determine the roots by applying the formula. Lambda is equals to minus b plus minus root of b square, 3 square, 9, minus 4, a, 1, c, 3, divided by 2a. And therefore, we get these values as minus 3 plus minus 9 minus 12. 9 minus 12 we get minus 3 by 2. And therefore, the remaining two roots are imaginary roots, as we have a root of negative term. And therefore, that values of lambda are minus 3 by 2 plus minus root 3 by 2 times I. And as we are getting imaginary values, we neglect this, we will not consider these values. Therefore, lambda equals to 6. For lambda equals to 6, we get that non-zero solution or infinite number of solution. Therefore, this is the way to solve that homogeneous type of equation. Therefore, I am using this condition. Second example, discuss the nature of the solution for different values of k for the given system of equation. Equations are x plus 2y minus z is equals to 0. Second equation is 3x plus k plus 7 times y minus 3z is equals to 0. And third equation is 2x plus 4y plus k minus 3 times z is equals to 0. Here once again, all the values on the right hand side equals to 0, means its type is homogeneous. And this two equation containing the term of k, it is somewhat difficult to perform by that canonical form technique. Therefore, we use the second method to determine the values of k. For that, here we write down the determinant of that A. Determinant of A is the determinant of matrix A, and that matrix A is the matrix of coefficient, and therefore the determinant is here containing elements 1, 2, minus 1, 3, k plus 7, minus 3, 2, 4 and k minus 3. Okay. And then evaluating this determinant, as we are evaluating third order determinant, therefore first element 1 into neglecting this row and this column and taking the determinant of this 4 elements, therefore that product is k plus 7 k minus 3 minus, and this minus it become plus 12. Then second element is with minus n, minus 2 into neglecting this row and this column and taking a determinant of the remaining 3 times k minus 3 minus minus plus 3 to the 6. Then third element is minus 1 into neglecting this row and this column and taking determinant of this 4. 4 to the 12 minus 2 times k plus 7. And then simplifying it, performing this product, k into k, we get k square. 7k minus 3k, 7k minus 3k, we get 4k. 7 3 is a 21 minus plus 12. Then minus 2 times 3k minus 6 plus 6. Sorry, minus 9 plus 6. Minus 9 plus 6. We get minus 3 minus 12 minus 14. 12 minus 14. 12 minus 14. We get minus 2 and minus 2k. And therefore, simplifying it further, we have k square plus 4k minus 21 plus 12 minus 9 minus 3 to the 6k minus minus plus 6 minus minus plus 2 and minus minus plus 2k. And therefore, simplifying it, we have k square 6k minus 6k get cancelled. 6 plus 2, 8 minus 9. 8 minus 9, we get minus 1. Therefore, this is the simplified value of determinant of A. And then we have to determine the values by using that condition for zero solution. Required condition is determinant of A not equals to zero. Therefore, the determinant is here k square minus 1 not equals to 0. That is, k square is not equals to 1. Means k is not equals to, if we take a square root on both sides, we get plus minus 1. Therefore, for these values of k, k is not equals to plus 1 or k is not equals to minus 1, we get zero solution. Then for non-zero solution, a required condition is determinant of A must be equal to zero. That is, here determinant value is k square minus 1 equals to 0. That is, k square equals to 1. That is, taking square root, we get k equals to plus minus 1. Therefore, these are the values of k for which we get non-zero solution, and these are the values of k for which we get zero solution. Therefore, with the help of these two examples, I have explained how we can use that note to solve homogeneous type of equation. Therefore, this is the another important technique to solve homogeneous type of equation. Then, some examples for practice. Practice example, classwork example or homework problem. Example number one, investigate the values of lambda and mu for this equation, which have no solution, unique solution and infinite number of solution. Second, for what values of k this system of equation has no solution and infinite number of solution. And third, for what values of lambda the following equations have infinite number of solution. Therefore, try to solve all these three examples as a practice example in your notebook as per the things which I have covered in this lecture. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you so much.